Hey, darlings, let's have a look at today's transit lounge.
Here's the chart as a whole, and of course it's Aries season, which means the sun is in Aries over here. Let's take a closer look. And we've still got this pile on. Chiron's at 15 Aries, sun's at 10 Aries, Jupiter 18 Aries, so they are all conjunct in a stellium. Also Mercury at 24 degrees, which is just outside a 5-degree orb that we would use. And then we've got Venus conjunct Uranus. So Uranus at 16 Taurus. Wherever you have planets around 16, 17 Taurus, you've just had this Venus conjunct Uranus happening. So that's my ascendant at 17. So that's just happened on my ascendant. So you're not just getting a Venus transit this year, you're getting Venus and Uranus at this point. So that can include planet square, opposite, trine, all the rest. Remember, where is this landing in your personal birth chart? That's what really matters. Freaky Friday over here. Venus conjunct Uranus. So, relationships, Venus, or relating, or a person, maybe a Venusian type, but unusual. Unusual, something different, maybe a different way of making money as well. Venus in Taurus is certainly all about the value and the quality. Good for brainstorming in a way because Jupiter is over here with Mercury. Mercury's just moved past. So, what ideas have you come up with over the last week, basically? Could be interesting to look at. This is super interesting too. Different sort of style. Maybe you found an item that you like or had a breakthrough around, I don't know, your branding, even depending where this is falling. Mars is freshly into Cancer. I like to call this one angry crying. So the action principle is motivated by Cancerian themes. So emotionally motivated, direct beeline to the comfort food. It's a little bit shy. It will act to preserve and defend family or anyone close to. So as this Mars moves through, it's going to start squaring these planets in Aries because these two signs square. Moon is in Leo today for the next couple of days, so that's going to, well, it's already started trining across all of this area, so that's lots of fire, it's an additional fire, so great for party, social, being really active, getting some traction, being yang, lots of fun. I think that's fun, fire's fun, and it's energy. And of course, since we've last chatted, the biggest news of the year, which is Pluto having moved into Aquarius for the first time in a long time. It's going to backtrack twice. Pluto takes two steps forward and or one step back in terms of degrees. So it's going to enter two more times. On the third entry to Aquarius, it's going to move through at a very slow pace, taking 20 years for the whole thing. So wherever 0 degrees Aquarius or fixed signs are, it's already making this great big grand square today, actually, a bit of tension, is where Pluto is terraforming. This one's in my ninth house. What house of your birth chart hosts 0 degrees Aquarius? So this is the first time Pluto's been through Aquarius, actually, since the French Revolution, the Civil War, lots of tumultuous social upheaval and change, transformation, social transformation, sciences as well, invention, interesting times ahead. So, what's the other thing? And Saturn is freshly into Pisces. Neptune also representing in sign in Pisces. So, Saturn and Neptune could not be more different. Saturn's like a container or a boundary. Neptune is like infinity or the fog or the water or whatever dissolves, dissolution, dissolves the container, the wall, the boundary, and the barrier. But Saturn is in Neptune's sign, so Neptune dominates here. This is really interesting. Not going into it today, just pointing it out. But think about where Saturn, well, this time about 28, 29 years ago, Saturn was going through this part of your chart. So think back to then. If this is your Saturn return, if you have Saturn in Pisces, and this is your first Saturn return, happy Saturn return. If you are a millennial elder millennial, you are having your Pluto square. So this transiting Pluto is square to your natal Pluto. And if you are the youngest of the Gen X, Pluto and Libra Gen, you're also having your Pluto square. It's just kind of going to go back and forth and ping off the both of you. But yeah, moving into the square over the millennials, one of three signatures that indicate the midlife crisis. It's actually, I've just done an article looking at quite a lot of charts for the Pluto sextile, square, and then the trine. I'm just coming into the trine personally as a Gen X Pluto and Libra elder. That's the second half of Gen X. So yeah, really interesting times. A lot of interesting stuff can happen at that square. So push on, push through. So enjoy the moon in Leo, have a dance, have a wrestle, get active, all that fire with Aries as well. I've been your host, Vanessa Montgomery from Astro All Stars. And of course, you can book in with me for a one-to-one bespoke astrological reading through my website at astroallstarswithaz.com, or pick up one of my books on astrology to learn the easy, simple way. Astro Power, a simple guide to prediction and destiny, could be your first port of call.